Hello guys, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be checking out Unreal Tournament, updated to the latest version of Unreal Engine, Unreal Engine 5.7. If you guys aren't familiar with Unreal Tournament, this was Epic's fast-paced first-person shooter game that ended up being cancelled, but the assets were released as part of the original UE4 project. And in this video, I'm taking those Unreal Tournament 4 assets straight from the UE4 project and dropping them into a fresh Unreal Engine 5.7 project. We're going to be checking out how the map looks and feels with modern UE5 features with the Lumen Global Illumination, the reflections, and much more. And I did make a video about this 2 years ago, back in 2023, and a lot of you guys actually back then showed a ton of interest in acquiring these files so you could actually play around with it for yourself. And so I have actually not only packaged this game as a playable demo that you can download right now in the description below, but I'm also going to be making a second follow-up video showcasing all of the assets that come in this project, but also I'm going to be leaving a download zip file for them, as Epic Games has unfortunately terminated the GitHub project or server where you could download the original assets, and hopefully someone at Epic doesn't cease and desist me. And if you guys are new here to the channel, my name is Smart Poly. I make all sorts of Unreal Engine news and content, and if you are interested in learning Unreal Engine for game development, I have some exciting news. My Unreal Engine 5 multiplayer survival game course bundle now has a 25% off limited time sale. To commemorate the launch of Unreal Engine 5.7, we're having a special 25% off discount, so use code UNREAL57 at checkout when you purchase the Survival Game Course Bundle. Get access to over 100 hours of learning content between both courses included in the single bundle, and kickstart your game development journey today. So check it out, link in the description below, or head over to my website, smartpoly.teachable.com, to learn more. And with all that out of the way, let's get right into the video. So yeah, here we are in the main level. This is actually the outpost level. And so here is the view overlooking sort of like this waterfall and the landscape off in the distance. And so this is in Unreal Engine 5.7, the most recent release, 5.7.1 actually. We have the lumen lighting, the reflections and all that stuff. I didn't have nanite enabled in this scene because you really don't need nanite. And I'll show you guys like the wireframe here in a second. But all these assets are pretty well optimized because they were used back in Unreal Engine 4. And so yeah, this is what the scene looks like. I actually did try to crank up some of the lumen lighting in here, but unfortunately, I was getting like an insanely low frame rate, so I just set it back to the defaults, kept it all as the default settings. So yeah, let's go ahead and head over here. So I went ahead and checked this out about 2 years ago. And the thing about the original project was that I actually didn't have like lumen or the lighting actually set up properly, so a lot of the interiors, like this room in particular, none of the lighting was actually set up with global illumination, so it was very dark in some of these interior scenes. But this scene, I actually fixed it in the project, so it has all the proper settings set up. We have some of the reflections there you can see on the ground, and it just looks overall a lot better. Now, obviously, you can see some of the artifacts with the lighting over there. And I didn't upgrade some of the lumen settings, so you can like tweak the quality. But I didn't do that because when I, you know, maxed out some of the settings, I was getting a very low frame rate. So I just kind of left everything as the defaults. Yeah, overall, it looks, I think, pretty decent. And here's the sort of exterior of the map. And let's try and go back inside over here. But I think Epic really needs to go ahead and make these assets free. Unfortunately, they discontinued the original Unreal Tournament project, the Unreal Tournament 4. And they made these assets, they put them available in this GitHub project. That's actually where I downloaded them before. But unfortunately, what they did was, after I think I made a video on it the first time, they discontinued the server that hosted the assets. So anyone who actually tried to go ahead and download them, they weren't actually able to do so. And I don't know if that was because of the video or just the amount of requests that people were making to try and download the assets, or, you know, it's just something that they shut off for some reason. I'm not sure, you know, what are the reasons. But honestly, they need to make these assets free. You know, they've done that with previous games like Paragon. They've done that with games like Infinity Blade. They've made all those assets free for anyone to use in Unreal Engine. And also, they could even make them free to use in, you know, UEFN or Unreal Editor for Fortnite. Because someone would definitely remake the Unreal Tournament game or franchise with these assets, you know, remastered. And the only reason I could think of for, you know, them not releasing these assets is probably because either they're working on something internally, maybe they're actually working on a remake themselves. So maybe that's the only reason. plausible reason for why they wouldn't just, you know, release these assets as a free download or asset pack that you could download from FAB. And also, I'm going to be making a follow-up video to this one. So make sure that you check out the next video that I'll upload, which will be about checking out the assets, all the assets that come with this project, because there's quite a bit that we don't see in just this level. Like, they had all of the vehicles from Unreal Tournament 3 downloaded and extracted, imported into this project. And so we're going to check out all the vehicles as well as a bunch of characters. So a bunch of high quality character meshes. They had like the first person arms version, as well as like the full body mesh. So there's just like loads of assets that the community would definitely benefit from being able to use them to create, you know, maybe games, maybe even learning content. Like myself personally, I wanted to create some sort of like Halo, Unreal Tournament, first person shooter inspired game that has like different types of vehicles. And honestly, for a time, I've been wanting to make a Halo 3 inspired course where, you know, you have like a first person shooter and I want to remaster one of the maps and add things like the vehicles and stuff. And when I found out that they have a ton of vehicles in this project, it kind of makes me want to just use that in creating that Halo-inspired first-person shooter course. But, you know, hopefully Epic doesn't see this and decides to, like, copyright strike me or DMCA strike my video or send me a cease and desist. That wouldn't be fun. Yeah, so you'll be able to download this project. I'll leave a link to the actual demo project in the description below. But like I said, I haven't modified any of the actual settings, so I haven't tried to like optimize the project or anything like that. So it might not run the greatest because it has all the default Unreal settings applied. And I don't have like an actual options menu in the game. So if you want to tweak some of the settings, have it like lower, set to lower quality, you'll need to go into the game user settings.ini file in order to tweak that. So just note that you're going to have to make those changes and adjustments yourself. I'm trying to see if there's any part of this map that I haven't explored yet. I feel like there are some different corridors that I remember from the game that you can jump through. Okay, so here is one of the different corridors over here. So they have sort of like this top area. And they had like launch pads, I'm pretty sure, where you could jump from one area to another. And yeah, this might have been one of those areas. I don't know if there was a jump pad or if you just jumped down over here and you ran through this area. But I think the movement in the game allowed you to jump pretty high, pretty far. It's been actually quite a while since I played. I think it was like the Unreal Tournament 4 beta. I don't know if you can actually still play the game itself. I think you can download it from the Epic Games Launcher. But yeah, let me know about that down in the comments down below. But yeah, I'm interested to hear you guys' thoughts on this because it's just pretty interesting to revisit this again, you know, a couple years later with, you know, some of the newer features of Unreal Engine, to just see how everything looks with all the lighting, the reflections. Okay, so I think we found actually the hatch that allows you to kind of jump down into this area. So yeah, this is where we can continue on. But yeah, I'm gonna try and test this demo out on my Steam Deck. I'll try to adjust some of the different settings. Maybe I'll even try to take this project and also experiment with the lighting. Like maybe I could do a comparison demo versus NVIDIA RTX Global Illumination, a branch of Unreal Engine versus Lumen, because I think these are some decent assets to actually, you know, mess around with. And the lighting would definitely look pretty cool to compare. And over here is sort of the outside part of the level. So yeah, look at the detail. What's neat about these assets is none of these assets have, you know, nanite. So this is the time before nanite where we're just using things like LODs, and a lot of the details in here are just in the textures itself. So they baked a lot of the details from the high poly mesh. And so they're just really nice to see something like this after we've had some of the other demos, like the, you know, Electric Dreams demo, the Matrix Awakens, where you just have those high quality nanite assets. It's just refreshing to see some of these older assets in a updated version of Unreal Engine. Okay, so here we are in the project itself, guys. And yeah, you can see all the different decals, all the geometry and everything. And I actually wanted to show you guys the wireframe. So yeah, check this out. You can see just all the detail of the assets. I really wish Epic would put out some more demos like this, just sample projects that are not super high poly or nanite quality. Just so that we can see some different examples of using assets like this in Unreal Engine 5. And yeah, let's go ahead and check out this main area over here. So yeah, just look at all the different details. In my previous original video, I actually enabled Nanite in the scene, which is totally unnecessary because you really don't need Nanite enabled. It's not super high poly detailed on the assets, and all of these have LOD set up already. So again, it's not really needed. So yeah, look at some of the details over here. Just makes you appreciate how much work, how much time and effort has been put into creating these assets. And again, I just really wish that Epic would consider making some of these assets just free to use for someone who either just wants to mess around, make a game, sort of like the same thing that they've done with the Paragon assets and also the Infinity Blade assets. So yeah, over here is this little cool vent. So yeah, it's just a shame that some of these assets will just go to waste. But who knows, you know, maybe they're working on some sort of internal Unreal Tournament remake. That's probably, you know, some hopium, but yeah, look at this little spinning. I'm not sure what you'd call this, like a little generator or something. All the little particle effects in there. So yeah, look at all the little details in here, the wiring, all the different pipes. And I don't think we checked out this room. This is like sort of like this fan room. And we'll need to make like an interactable demo. Right now I kind of just have a simple first person character with a weapon that you can walk through. I think they had like jump pads and stuff in here. So I don't have those, obviously. I don't think like the blueprints are set up, or I don't even think we have those blueprints in here. But yeah, just look at all of that. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. So let me know what you guys think about this down in the comments down below. And also stay tuned for that second video where we'll check out the assets and I'll add a downloadable file for all the assets so you can mess around in your Unreal Engine 5 projects as well. So that's pretty much it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed and I'll see you guys in the next one.